You caught me at a busy time. You have the smell of soot about you.
Did you?
So you brought some much-needed joy into the dour lands of Stone Falls? It warms my heart to share the New Life Festival.
Thank you.
What might these magic trinkets do? I leave it to you to discover.
This is taking longer than I'd planned.
Thank the Eight. Bankrai Pass is safe again. It's such a high cost.
Quite busy, can't you see?
A gladiator's life is simple. Fight and live, or fight and die. Sometimes I envy that.
For the favor of Morhua.
What is it?
And you do well to loosen that codpiece. By the eight, what a killjoy.
You're back, I see. How could I not? You're standing in my light. So tell me, how did you do? Well, good for you. But don't get too full of your accomplishments just yet. That was a fairly easy contract I started you with. Come back when you're ready for more. If the speaker or the matron give an order, though, that takes priority.
Sermonizer is at it again.
Those loudmouth fanatics!
It's time to teach them a lesson about the blessings of silence!
Enough. I'll decide how we respond to these malign sermons. Initiate, I have a task for you. Once again, the pious idiots of Kvatch dare to provoke the anger of the Dark Brotherhood. Such an insult cannot be allowed to stand unchallenged. As if the Grand Sermonizer didn't have enough vices to rage about, now she's preaching against the Brotherhood. She says we are weak, powerless, a toothless dragon that inspires ridicule instead of fear. These lies must be silenced. Permanently. Be wary. The Order of the Hour has increased its presence in Kvatch. Avoid the warrior priests if you can. Meet up with Tanik and silence the priests that speak against us, including the Grand Sermonizer. That will put the fear of Sithis in them. Tanik will meet you in Kvatch. I expect the two of you to deal with the Grand Sermonizer and show the people of that hypocritical city the real power of the Dark Brotherhood.
Initiate, I have my own contract in Kvatch. I'll join you in Tanik as soon as I'm finished.
Three blades on the same contract? Is that wise, Matron?
Just make sure the Grand Sermonizer dies, Initiate. That's my chief concern.
Next.
I was wondering how long it would take you to get here. Didn't Astara instill you with a sense of urgency about this mission? She must be getting tender-hearted after all these years. Yes, I say so. I find life to be a complicated series of pranks and pratfalls. Besides, this is your mission. I'm only here to observe and offer assistance if you get in over your head. Speaking of which, try not to get captured or killed today. No, that would be boring. You start murdering the Sermonizer's priests while I take on the real challenge. I'll locate her hiding spot. Then I'll find you so we can kill her together. That will put the fear of the Brotherhood in the Kvatch people. Be stealthy or slaughter everyone that gets in your way. Whichever works best for you. They all wind up with Sithis in the end, so what's the worry? Now, let's get out there and deal with the Grand Sermonizer and her lying priests. Time to dip our daggers in Sermonizer blood. Watch your back, New Blade.
Merchandise. First hold, so much death. I hear the place still smells of fire. And death.
There's a hidden evil corrupting Kvatch. Wicked fool!
Power's in her family's estate outside Kvatch. I'll meet you there, New Blade. And if you really want to impress the matron, a few more sermonizers along the way.
I speak of the foul followers of Sithis.
I saw that, and I'm going to tell the guards.
Don't look away. Thank you.
These villains are cowards, hiding in the shadows. They are toothless dragons, powerless, frightened.
Done. Someone help!
Another distraction.
The Dark Brotherhood. Cowards and skeever lovers. The lot of them.
Merchant to the Jarls.
Murder is a filthy business in the eyes of Akatosh.
Do not fear the Dark Brotherhood. They are children compared to Akatosh.
Ublade, come quietly and listen. Our quarry stirs below.
Grand Sermonizer, have you discovered the location of the sanctuary yet?
Unfortunately, this assassin expired before revealing anything useful.
I'll capture another. Try not to kill this one before we learn the location of the Dark Brotherhood's lair.
Lord Akatosh, hear our prayer.
Just prepare the body, like so.
Who is that black-armored warrior? Some kind of mercenary. Now's our chance. Follow me. Tortured Simbar. Such an insult to the family cannot stand. At least he knew how to hold his tongue. What foul magic is this? Newblade, beware. I feel so weak. I can't move.
Two assassins? I didn't know they came in pairs. With the proper motivation, you will be this is unexpected, but I refuse to die here.
I'm just gonna sit here and see who comes for me first. Sithis or Tall Papa?
Tanik! Are you planning to just lay down and die?
He would come for Simbar. Trapped his body with some kind of foul death magic.
Get up, you milk drinker! Sithis still has work for you to do. Initiate! The Grand Sermonizer is yours. I'll get Tanik home.
Defend me, Knights of the Order of the Hour! Show this assassin the true power of Akatosh! I'll need to use something harsher.
Kor brought Tanik home injured but alive. He told me you went after the Grand Sermonizer. Tell me, has the deed been done? Simbar was one of our best. To allow himself to be captured like that. I didn't think that either the Grand Sermonizer or the Order of the Hour was capable of such a feat. Why go to all that trouble, I wonder? Black armor. I've heard rumors of such a warrior. But to seek the location of our sanctuary. It appears we're at war with an unknown adversary. I need to think about this. By the way, Tanik woke up and asked to see you.
Don't worry, Tanik. A cask of mead, and you'll be back on your feet in no time.
Yeah, your mead tastes like bee vomit. I think I'll pass.
Oh, Tanik, I hate that this happened to you.
You worry more than the matron, Hildegard. I'll be as good as new before you know it. Ah, the new blade has arrived. Give us the room if you would, Kor.
Certainly, Tanik. But I still expect you to be completing contracts again in a few days.
I'll do my best not to disappoint you.
Take your time, Tanik. I am going to go say a prayer for your quick recovery.
Kor and Hildegard mean well, but they're worse than a couple of mother hens. You're alive. Does that mean the Grand Sermonizer is no longer with us? We're not certain what kind of magic the Grand Sermonizer placed upon Simbar's body. But I'd be dead too, if not for you and Kor. I'm indebted to you both. And I'll make sure that everyone remembers Simbar's bravery. He refused to give up our secret, no matter what the Grand Sermonizer did to him. It does make me wonder about the warrior who was able to defeat him, though. Simbar could easily best me in a fight, and that warrior bested him. If you encounter her again, don't underestimate her skills and abilities. She's hunting the hunters, and that's a game I have no desire to play. A chance to beat your record. How many of the Sermonizer's priests did you murder anyway? Seriously, New Blade, stay sharp out there. The roots of our trouble stretch deep below the soil. Things are gonna get worse, my friend. Mark my words.